Hello, my name is Jonathan Barr, and on behalf of my co-authors, I'm excited to present our study published in Allergy, Skin Tape Stripping Revealed Distinct Biomarker Profiles in Chronic Hand Eczema of Patients with and Without Comorbid Atopic Dermatitis. Chronic hand eczema, or CHE, is a common and debilitating skin condition that significantly impacts patients' quality of life. Our research uses a novel, minimally invasive technique, skin tape stripping, to explore the molecular underpinnings of CHE and its subtypes. In our study, we recruited 66 patients with moderate to severe chronic hand eczema, that is, 33 with and 33 without comorbid atopic dermatitis, along with 20 healthy controls. Tape strip samples were collected from lesional and non-lesional skin of affected patients, as well as matched samples from healthy individuals. For those unfamiliar with tape stripping, it is a minimally invasive technique where adhesive tape is applied to the skin and then removed to collect cells from the outer layers. This method provides a convenient and non-invasive way to perform molecular profiling, eliminating the need for traditional skin biopsies while still offering high-resolution insight into disease mechanisms. Our analysis revealed that non-lesional skin in chronic hand eczema exhibits a hybrid phenotype. It demonstrates characteristics that overlap with both lesional CHE and healthy control skin. This hybrid state is marked by dysregulated immune and epidermal barrier biomarkers, albeit to a milder extent compared to lesional skin. Revealed that chronic hand eczema is characterized by differing immune profiles in patients with atopic dermatitis comorbidity compared to those without. For example, lesional skin in patients with AD showed a stronger type 2 inflammatory response with upregulation of markers such as IL-13 and CCL17. In contrast, CHE patients without AD exhibited a more pronounced type 1 immune response, characterized by upregulation of marker like IL-15RA and CXCL9. Thank you for your attention. For more details, please read our article in Allergy. We are grateful to our collaborators for supporting this research.